Hey guys, welcome to the Testing Academy. My name is Pramod, and today we have with us Sanjay Kumar, who is a creator of Gruopath. Gruopath is a tool which can save your time while creating your automation scripts and can help you to find better locators. Like, these are just the few of the functionality that I am discussing, and it's an awesome tool, trust me guys, and it's very much useful to the people who are just starting out their career in software testing and in automation testing. Like, and even if you are at an advanced level, this tool can change your life and can save your lots of efforts that you are creating, basically your effort that you waste while creating your automation frameworks. All right, so let's see what is there in the video, and I hope you will like the content. Welcome, Sanjay. How are you?
Thank you, Pramod. I'm doing well, very well. How are you?
I'm doing good. I know it's a quite difficult time right now, and there are lots of different things going on. I hope you are fine, and I hope our viewers are also fine. Right.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Let's start with what is it means. Consider me as a totally new noob kind of a thing, and I just wanted to know what is Gruopath. And over to you. Let's start.
Thank you, Pramod. Thank you. Yeah. So I will quickly start with a few things what are the problems we are facing today, or how we are writing the how we are writing the XPath selectors, and how tough it is, and where all we are wasting our time, precious time, and where all we are doing the manual things again and again. So let me show you how we you can disagree with me at any point of time if you feel like no, this is not the way that we are doing. Mm-hmm. So for an example, you see, if we have to write the selector, one selector, let's say mm-hmm. for this network, we have to write. You ask me, Sanjay, can you write a XPath for this network, my network?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is how you will inspect this element, mm-hmm. and then you will do command F, right? And here you will type your XPath like in DevTools. So we do command F, /// span, you type. And as soon as you type the span, you see that DOM got scrolled. Up and down,
mm-hmm.
right? Then again, you will have to inspect this element because you can't remember that complete DOM, what was there.
Mm-hmm.
And then you see class and the network is there. So let's say a class could be like many times. So we'll consider the text here.
Mm-hmm.
And you see as soon as again, it gone up and down. Again, you will have to inspect that element or you will scroll in DOM. Agree with me? Are you guys doing the same with it? See, as soon as I type, if the double quotes again it gone my network, then I have to check it again whether N was capital or small. So it was this one. Let me copy this.
Mm-hmm.
Agree with me? Hope you are doing this way only.
So yes, definitely.
This is
yes,
one of
yeah.
one.
Yeah.
Okay. So again inspecting again and again and typing, you see that how much pain we are taking. And if this XPath couldn't be unique in just one single selector. For example, here, let me write one more XPath for you here for this products element.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say we have to write the XPath for this products when we have to go for the parent hierarchy and all. So here you will do command F and then you will type here /A. Okay, mm-hmm. again it's gone, and then text, let's say it was products, so it came. Then you see as soon as we are typing, this DOM view is going up and down and we don't know where all. Mm-hmm. So here it is one of two. Now if we have to make it we will have to make it parent child combination, so then you will type it from this one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's say /li, and then id we can use. So when we are typing, basically, so it's a lot of time we are wasting here inspecting element again and again, back and forth. So that's where we are wasting a lot more time. If I would have, we would have started the timer, we could have seen what all time we are wasting. Let us solve this problem with the help of Gruopath and see how can we build our own XPath
mm-hmm.
with the help of Gruopath, and how can we save a lot more time. And you don't believe, in many forums I have seen this question, people asking, should we build our own XPath or use Gruopath? So this is a very misconception across the people, many people or beginners that GoPath can be used as an XPath generator. No, it is very helpful while learning and while writing your own XPath. So let's see, how can you learn to write better XPath, and how can you write your own XPath in better way and save time? So here you have a span class, and if you have GoPath installed, then it's good. If you haven't installed, you can install it from here. This is a page, and there you have all the links here. So okay, just for reference. So if you have already installed, GoPath will be the last tab here. Sometimes it is not visible because it is hidden here. So you can click on GoPath here, or just for better view, you can expand it so it will be visible always here.
Okay.
Now you see that span. Here you type your XPath. //span. You see it is, the DOM is not scrolling up and down, and I need not to inspect that element again and again. And as soon as you see, like when I'm typing, if this format is not correct, you see it will highlight here, it will highlight. So this is learning for you, that you know that this is an incorrect format, this kind of is incorrect format. If you will be typing similar kind of thing here in dev tools, it, you will not get to know that this this is a wrong format, like it is showing 0 of 0. So you are feeling that this correct XPath is correct format, but actually this is not the correct XPath pattern. So if you are a beginner, you don't know how to write the XPath, you got to know that this is a wrong format. Like, so you will immediately get to know that where is you are doing wrong, this is a correct format. So it immediately highlights what wrong you are doing, like somewhere you have typed double quotes and somewhere by mistake you did single quote, then it will highlight. So that's where, like, you do it makes you good learning. And then here you type my network, and you see that how much time we saved, and you hit enter, it got 1 of 1 matching node, and it is giving you here the element, as well as it's highlighting in the UI as well, like you see that this element is the one. So it helps a lot, like building your own XPath. Now here you come, like we were typing here, a lot of effort we were taking, inspecting element again and again. Just you can have the better view here, left side, right side you type A, and here, and no interruption in between, like it's not going up and down. So that makes life so easy. And you can see that.
Okay.
When you hit enter, it will highlight, it will give all the matching nodes here. So you see in DevTools itself, like all the matching nodes. And if it is the second matching node somewhere hidden, it will scroll up. Like you see this product is the second element. If it is hidden somewhere, mm-hmm. when mm-hmm. you will mouse over on the second element, it will scroll up and make it front in the UI. So that also there. And this is first and this is second. And it highlight in different color, like first matching node in green color and rest matching node in blue dashed outline. So a lot more things are there, we will discuss in this session. So that's how it helps a lot. And you see that how much learning, as a beginner, I don't know how to write the XPath and what are the correct format and if it is correct format or not. So that, like, as soon as you type here, it shows you those error messages and all. But here, if you might have done similar thing here in DevTools, it will show you 0 of 0. You might be thinking, yeah, this is showing me 0 of 0. Is it correct format or not? Wrong. Suppose if you are you just started learning today automation and writing automation script, by looking at this, would you be able to tell that this is a wrong format? No. So that's where it helps a lot.
Wonderful, wonderful. So yeah. It basically,
if you have any question,
No. I just got exactly what is it. And so we can have like multiple XPaths. So means it basically gives us suggestions, right? Along with it, that yes, you can use other XPaths also, right? I can see that there are like a couple of other options are also coming.
Yeah. So I'm coming to that. So this was the very basic and very useful feature, which is actually being used by almost a very much used feature. And this was the only reason initially GoPath was adopted like anything in the beginning, because first it was launched as an editor and whole world accepted, because there was no other solution where you can have the view here and you can type it here. Similar thing was there in Firefox. That was a challenge always. Like once that Firepath was down, and earlier there was no possibility. Now with the Firefox latest version, still you would be able to type here and you can verify XPath. But earlier you had to go to console, and I'm sure like you must be aware that we used to do $X, and then that's how we used to verify our XPath.
Yeah, that was a bigger pain. Yeah.
Yes. So that's where like Prabhupada got so much help here, that you just open your tab here and right, left side you got the DOM access, right side you type and verify. So that makes life so much easier for people, and people adopted Prabhupada like anything, and it saves a lot more time for them. Okay. Now, next to your question. Mm-hmm. Yes. So now this is the help for the people, those who want to write their own XPath, or they want to, or someone who is a beginner and they want to learn how to write XPath or CSS selector. Actually, you can also here, you can verify your CSS selectors as well. Like let's say you want to write your CSS selector, you do this way, href or whatever, like let's say item prop and this URL. So hit enter, it will tell you like if it is matching node or something else I typed wrong. So yeah, so that's how like it helps you. You can verify your XPath or CSS selector both. So it is an editor for selectors, basically, you can say.
Oh, now, cool.
Now coming to the next thing, that this mm-hmm. is okay. So this is how it is helping as an editor.
Mm-hmm.
Now, next big thing is Prabhupada also suggests you just in single click all types of selector. We all have this question in mind, and we always have been asked that whether XPath we should use ID, class, or any other locator or XPath, right?
Mm-hmm.
It is always suggested that we should use ID, class, or any locator which is like more performance is better and robust. But is there anything which can suggest the beginner or someone like us, those who already know this skill, like we know how to write XPath and all, and now we are in hurry, we want to do wrap up or complete our work fast and maintain the things quickly, and we don't want to waste our time in that mm-hmm. case, like is there anything which can tell us that looking at this, can you tell me, looking at the DOM, can you tell me that ID is unique, class is unique, name is unique, you can, Sanjay, you can use the A, tag name A, it will be work in your script. Can anyone tell us, until unless we will not form our own selector or own XPath or own CSS selector, nobody can tell us just looking at this DOM, right?
Mm.
There are so many attributes, nobody can tell me that Sanjay, you can use ID, you can use class name, or you can use the name. No, no. Until unless we will not verify them, what is the occurrences? There could be 5 times this name in this page, there could be ID, this could be like dynamic ID, like if I will refresh this page, this might got changed, this class could be used in this page 100 times, and it could be like multiple times. So there is nothing like which can tell you that looking at the DOM, this is the, these are all possible selector for this element. But with the Prabhupada, this is possible. Let me show you how. Like for this element, let's say we inspected this element, and you see immediately Prabhupada tells that, see, for this ID is unique, 1 occurrence, class name, this is 7 times. So you should not use class. It is saving showing 7 in orange color. So that means this is some kind of alert it is telling you. Then CSS mm-hmm. selector 1 matching node, tag name span 182 times. So you we shouldn't use this. So this tells us with the occurrences of the selectors, as well as what all possible selector for this element. Now we need not to waste time. Just in single click, you see all possible selectors is telling us relative XPath, class name, CSS selector, absolute XPath, tag name. What all possible things is there? It will tell you that. So for this, it is suggesting like all these are possible. Now it's up to you what you want to use. So easy it is. So time saving it is. So that's how it helps a lot. And it also add the alert icon here. You see, if ID looks like dynamic, Ember 123, Ember 18 here. So whenever any ID or class, it will look found as an alphanumeric value, it will highlight that in it will give you some alert that this looks like dynamic, and if you mouse over on this, it will tell you what you can do. So you can uncheck the ID, it will generate with something else. You can generate with class, you can uncheck the class. So that's how it helps a lot. And you can just like in single click, you can generate the any kinds of elements or selectors, and it will make a lot easier for you.
Amazing.
Yeah. So that's how like it helps a lot. It just in single click, it generates everything. It shows you everything, all the information. And you won't believe like the XPath, what CrowPath generates, that is like next level algorithm. It without any, you see like the kind of XPath it will generate and the kind of XPath we used to write manually, that's like pretty much good XPath it used to generate. You can trust on this. Let me show you one XPath. If you write the XPath for this element, so here you see input, and if we write it manually, so what we will do, input, okay, it will scroll up and down and then say, let's say name is equal to email. You see 1 of 5 it is showing.
Mm-hmm.
We'll, to make it unique, we will go to parent.
Right.
Oh God. And then we'll go to parent, and this is the parent. So this we will type here. /div@ class is equal to, is still 1 of 5. Then we will again one more parent up. You do this way or some other approach you follow?
Mostly this is like the same thing,
yeah,
that we follow.
Yes. Actually, I have worked for like around 4-5 years as dead, so I know like what is the pain point for us, and we all, I mean, what kind of daily job we do. So this is how we all do.
Right.
And let me copy this XPath, what XPath we got it from. So we have written this XPath, this long XPath, you see. And now let me inspect the element, the same element for which we have written XPath. So this is the XPath which CrowPath is giving you. You see, /input, this input, it has combined with the unique parent, this one, and it has elapsed all this middle thing. And that's how it makes the robust and unique XPath, which you can use in your script and it will work in your next run. And there's nothing like dynamic thing here. And you see, if we would have looked at this element, immediately we would have used the either placeholder or name locator, because they looks like pretty much unique, right? Name email, we could have tried in R script, and then R script might got failed. So it tells us like name is 5 times, class name is 8 times, don't use them. And this is the best one. So this you can use it. And this is what we have written. So it helps a lot. It makes really good selector, good XPath.
Wonderful.
Thank you. Next, this is basically dark theme which you are seeing. There's an option to change the dark theme in DevTools so that you can try. How to install Autonomic CrowPath? It's very simple. You just go to autonomic.io/CrowPath. This is a homepage of CrowPath, and you can download it from here. It's very simple. Like it available for 4 browsers: Chrome, Firefox, Opera, and Edge browser. This current version is available for Chrome and Edge browser. Currently the one which I'm showing, that is 6.0. It will very soon, it will be coming for Firefox, this version. Already available for Firefox, that is 5.0. Here you see just a single click downloads is there. Whichever browser you want to download, this is the homepage. Here, from here you can download.
Okay.
And there are like lot more advanced features. So Pramod, if you have any suggestion or any question, feel free to ask, or you can stop me in between. Shall we continue?
Yeah, please go on.
Okay, sure. So let me show you some really advanced and time saver feature, and you won't believe like how much effort you can save using those features. So the first one, complete the locator space for page object model within a minute. So let me show you here something. When I was in when I used to write the locators or automation script, I used to write like my locators in this kind of format in the locators file. So you see, here this is the XPath which I have written. If I would have to like complete this page one by one, so how we would be doing, like we will copy pasting this, replacing this command, this XPath here, and this label from here, like right, and
right.
And then we'll go back here, we will open the DevTools, then we will inspect this, And suppose you have X crow path. So what you will do, you will copy this X path value from here. You will come back here, and then here you will paste the X path value. Then here you will type something products that we will give that this is the for product. And people can have like different kinds of command. How many people might be using this at find by X path value and then something like this, right? The command which we people used to have, like it is something like double forward slash, let's say this is the X path and there is some box, let's say. So many people write this kind of page object model, right? Now to complete this complete page, every time copy this, then paste this, then go back to browser, inspect the element, and then copy the XPath, come back here, then paste your XPath here, then edit it, again paste it. That will take like a whole lot day just to complete one page and lot of effort. Why don't we do it like in single go? Can we complete this complete page in single go? Can we write this kind of automation script just like within a minute? This kind of script, like if we have to type, if you ask me, Sanjay, write an automation script to get text of all these headers, how much time will it take for me? Like manually, if I will do one by one, it will take me at least half an hour. But can we do it like quickly? Yes, we can do it. Let me show you. So what you do, there is a click to generate automation code or multiple XPath. Click on this. Now you click on products. You inspect all these elements, which all you want. You see XPath is generating for them and products features label name is generating for them. It's telling you that this is for this one, this for this one. So these are the XPath. And if you feel like anything, like you don't want to generate with ID and all, that options are there. We'll come to later then. Now here, all XPath got generated. Okay, you can copy these XPath by clicking on this copy all button. Now you got the XPath, but you must be thinking like this is XPath. I mean, we will think like this is XPath only, right? But still we will have to edit something in them while writing our page object model. So let's finish this completely. You just turn on this command. You see everything is there. Rubber.findElement. Now you click on this, come back here in my script page and you paste it here. You asked me to get the get text and just finish. And my script is ready. You see, all headers are ready just in few seconds. Like I can complete as many as you want, and it will not take much time for me. Isn't it so easy? Now let me show you. And you can delete all button. Lots of features are there to complete your automation, everything. Now let's say we have to complete this kind of page. So how can we do that? So here is the trick. That you just copy this command wherever you have written your XPath. If it is inside double quotes, then inside double quote, or if it is not inside double quote, that's fine. Just replace the XPath with XPath value keyword. And this is just one time effort. I will tell you how. XPath is equal to XPath value, and wherever you have written your label, basically key for your XPath, replace that with label value. Okay. Now copy this command, come here. Replace this command here. Now you inspect this header, let's say, and there you go, your complete page is getting ready.
Wow.
And you see everything is got ready.
Interesting.
Yeah, you click on copy button. You can also export this file into file like later you want to use, or I found this is much easier. Just come back to your editor and you see the magic. Let me paste it here. You see, you go. It's wonderful. Already the command which we have written is here, and all the label whatever we used to write it manually, that's there. And if you're writing this kind of command, and this is not at all depend on any language, support Ruby, Python, Java, Selenium, Cucumber, Catalan, Studio, Twitter, whatever framework it is, whatever language it is not at all dependent on any language, any automation framework. It supports everything. If you have this kind of command, you come here, delete this, and you inspect this. And it's getting ready for you. And you can copy this, come back anywhere, and you can paste it here. So this is basically your, this kind of page object. Because I feel like many people write these kinds of pet find by or any command. So the only thing is you just have to replace this XPath with your XPath value in your command, and wherever you are writing label with label value. And this is just one time effort. You need not to set every time, because we know that everyone, like if in your framework, that command is always going to be fixed. So if you will close this, and next time when you will open CrowPath, this command is already set there. So it will be very fast for you. Now this time you come here, you see, need not to set the command. It's there. So you click and you go. So next time onwards, you will not have to worry. It is all your configuration will be saved here. And if you want to reset them, there is a reset. Click to reset all config. You click on this, it will take you to the default command, which we have given. And you see this one, anything you type here, anything. So that's where, like, it is, we don't care like what kind of command is there. We just care about like wherever you are writing XPath in your command, just replace that with XPath value. Got and it. You inspect. So whatever language it is, whatever it will support.
Okay, got it.
So hope this will help you a lot, to you and your viewers, your audience. And yeah, everybody always, like everyone is loving about all these features, and they're saving a lot more time. And this second feature is already I showed you, save all config in local. So no more time waste. Like, because earlier this command was not saving in 5.0 version. So every time when you open CrowPath, you had to set this command like as per your framework. But now that is not the case. If you come here, that command will always be saved. And this all features are available here as well. Like let's say you just want to generate one XPath with this command. So here also you just turn on this command, it will be appended on your XPath. And for other selectors as well, you see by.xpath, by.id, class name, it will automatically convert them. Selectors.
Nice.
Moving on, CP will suggest the relative XPath for user selectors. So this is very interesting and very useful feature for the beginners as well as for saving the time, those who are like literally in hurry and they don't want to waste at all time. And for the beginner is like too good. Suppose I'm a beginner and I don't know how to write the good XPath. So many times you might have seen in industry, people write random kinds of XPath, which you don't feel like good XPath. So for example, let's say copy this XPath from DevTools and see the value, what value we got it. We got something, this kind of value from DevTools. You see, pretty much indexes is used, single class, single forward slash. If you if your developer comes and a small change will happen in between, this XPath will break, right? Because this absolute XPath pretty much, and ID is there.
Right.
So now if you have written this kind of XPath, or let's say this kind of XPath, this is the XPath. Many people sometimes copy this kind of XPath, and you will see, like if they are beginner or they don't know how to write good XPath, they will use send some kind of these things. Suppose now if you have this XPath, what you do, you come here and hit enter. CrowPath will suggest you the better XPath for your selector. This is the XPath CrowPath is suggesting. In place of this, you use this XPath. If you mouse over on this, it will suggest you that CP suggested XPath. So it's helped a lot like this way. And suppose I'm a beginner and I'm typing XPath for, let's say, we were trying to form the XPath for this element, right? And that was taking some time here. Let's say we are trying input, and then name is equal to email. And we want to make it unique, but we are not able to make it unique. You hit enter, it will find five matching notes are there, and it's telling you this is the first matching note for the one which you are trying to write. And you see immediately you got it. We haven't wasted at all any time. So if somebody is beginner and he's trying to make the unique XPath, but he's not able to make it, he's not able to traverse through the DOM, and he never did that. So that's where it will help a lot to them. And they can learn like how can, what could be the better XPath. If they have written somewhere some kind of XPath, they can come here in CrowPath, they can paste it and see like whether they have written good XPath or not. So it's helped a lot in this way. And it's like, it is very helpful in many scenarios. Let's say, let's consider for the beginner, and the current situation is like everybody will be jobless. I mean, lots of jobs are people are losing jobs and there are a lot of interviews happening and people are looking to learn many things. Suppose an interview, somebody asks you how many link are there on this page and can you give me the XPath for the first link on this page? How quickly you can do? /A, hit enter. It will give you 38 all the links in this page. How many links are there? And this is the XPath for the first link on this page. Suppose someone asks you like how many input tags are there, input box in this page. You hit enter, it will tell you that immediately, and this is the XPath for the first input box on this page. So it helps a lot in that, those kinds of scenario. And one can save a lot more time.
Right, right. That makes sense.
Yeah. Moving on. Options to generate dynamic XPath with attributes with and without text. So yeah, so basically dynamic attributes are dynamic XPaths are those XPaths for which we think attributes are dynamic. So this has all those options here. Like let's say here it is generating with ID and you feel that ID is dynamic. Let me generate with some other ID which we feel that it could be dynamic. So for example, this ID, menu item 21775, it is generating and it's telling you that ID looks like dynamic for you. So you just uncheck the ID, it will generate without ID. Now it's generating with class and you don't want with class, you uncheck the class as well. So all those shortcuts are there. Like here it is generating with, let me check this, and so it is generating with ID and text, whatever it is generating, but you are not happy with this, you want to generate with some attribute, your own attribute, item prop you want to generate. So you can pass the attribute here, item prop, and hit enter. It will generate the XPath with your attribute. You see, it is, this is the XPath it is generating now, and it's good for you and you can use it. So basically, like because in industry everybody used to suggest that we should use some kind of data ID or QA ID in our automation framework to write the robust automation, so that like automation will not break in next run or if any changes happen. So that's where this concept comes, and it will be saved in your local. Like let's say data ID, QA ID is there in your framework attribute, which is unique for each element. Then you generate XPath with them and just pass here. And if that attribute is not available for any element, it will generate with some other selectors, other attributes. And if it is item prop, will be there. First preference will be item prop. So basically, this is a preference. It will give you the preference to your attribute.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Moving on. Yeah. CrowPath gives the iframe XPath. Oh my God. This is such an incredible and innovative feature. And from the beginning, the web came in picture. People are wasting a lot of time. I don't know why it has not been done yet. But yes, now it is here. So we can save a lot more time. There's nothing is there which can tell us that this pic, Sanjay, this Disney Hotstar, this is inside iframe or what. If you right click here, you see, did you find like immediately that this element is looking at this, that this is inside iframe? Or just let me just close this here, that inspect here, this element is inside iframe or not. Right, nothing can tell you that this element is iframe, inside iframe. Or better example, let me give here, looking at this, do you get to know that this element is inside iframe if you right click here?
Like not in the like first view, I guess.
Sorry,
I mean in first, if I say like a first view, I don't think it's on for like it's in iframe.
So you see when we right click here, right click, it will not tell you even when you inspect. So what we will do, we used to do, we just right either we here in DevTools, we used to do Command F and immediately we start writing our own XPath and we use that in a script, and that script start failing, that element not found. And we I personally, when I used to write the automation script, I wasted a lot more time, like half day, sometime full day, that element here it is showing 1 of 1, but why my script is failing, that is showing 0, element not found, and scratching it. And if you don't believe me, if we don't have good experience, that we it immediately it will not strike in our mind that this element could be inside iframe, and then sudden it will strike that this could be inside iframe. Then you will inspect this element and then you will scroll here in DOM and then see, oh my God, this was inside iframe. But if you have CrowPath, and then first you will write the XPath for this element which you have inspected, and then you will have to write the XPath for the iframe because you have to switch inside that, or your ID or whatever you use. what you have to do, you just open CrowPath, everything you got it, just ready-made, no, nothing you have to waste your time. You see, XPath for the element which you have inspected, this one, where you have to type last name, and the XPath for the iframe inside which this element is lying. Now, you just click on copy, you got this XPath, use this XPath, switch inside the frame, you use this XPath, and you got to know that this element is inside iframe. So you need not to waste your time while executing and figuring out that this element, why this script is failing, element not found. It helps a lot in that way.
This is like one of the wonderful, I was saying that this is like one of the wonderful, I guess, I have been like, lots of time I was in struggling to find iframe, basically it is in iframe or not.
Yes.
Man, yes. This is amazing.
Yes.
Yeah, carry on.
Thank you. Yeah. So you see that you, as soon as you inspect element, immediately it tells you that this is inside iframe and this is the iframe XPath and this is the relative XPath. Here is one catch, like this will work for those iframes which are from the same source. Basically, like if this iframe has been here made from the linkedin.com only. And that iframe, same source. And if it is iframes or if any iframe which is from different source, then it will not support there because for the obvious reason, browser doesn't allow to inject script inside the iframe which are from different source. Basically, those are Google Ads, those kind of things. Because iframe itself is introduced for security, right? If a captcha, if you are able to automate a captcha, then that's not a good captcha, right? So the captcha is introduced to stop automation. Similarly, iframe is for like security reasons. So, when you will be writing automation or you will be handling iframes, you will never come, hardly will come in that kind of situation where iframe will be from different. So yes. Otherwise, like it will solve your problem and it does. Very good job for you. Unique XPath for SVG elements and SVG child element. So far, there is nothing which can help you for the SVG elements. And even, I'm not sure like if you are aware about it, let's say this is the SVG element. So let me show you, if you right click here, copy XPath. Do you feel like this XPath will be working? The XPath which we copied from DevTools?
I don't think so.
You see that is nothing is showing. If you hit enter, nothing is happening here. And let's say copy this. Generally, it shows zero XPath here, zero matching node. Now, why is nothing is showing at all? So anyways, the XPath, even DevTools doesn't give you the unique XPath for SVG elements. You see? These are all SVG elements here. If you write like copy XPath, so 0 of 0 it is showing. Now you open CrowPath and you got the relative XPath and absolute XPath for this element, this child element SVG. So that's how it helps a lot. You see here, any SVG elements, CrowPath will give you the XPath. And for the beginners, it's really helpful, those who are looking how to write the XPath for SVG elements or SVG child element, because the format of writing XPath for SVG and SVG child elements is little different from the normal XPath which we used to write. So they can learn how to write the XPath for SVG elements and SVG child elements from here. They can look the what kind of format CrowPath is generating for this and how it is writing. So it is help a lot. It will help a lot for those who are looking to learn how to write a better XPath, how to write XPath for different kinds of elements.
Oh, wonderful.
Thank you. If you have any question, any suggestion so far, Pramod?
Yeah. So, are you done or do you have something else to want to discuss?
Yes. Few things, few more features I want to show you.
Yeah, please go on.
Which will blow your mind, definitely.
I'm just waiting for it, yeah. I was already. Yeah, I'm already sold because lots of features like iframes or those things, like these were like pain point. Means I have been into QA industry for like 8 years now, nearly. So these are like main pain points. Yeah.
Yes. And that's why like we feel those pain points and work on them day and night, and that's where like we come up with these innovations which solves everybody's problem. And have you ever heard if any engineer or any software engineer or engineer have ever called any software as a lifesaver tool. That's where engineers calling CrowPath as a lifesaver tool for engineers. So these are the innovations which makes it people giving such kinds of compliments and reviews, and you can read it across like on Google Chrome Store, LinkedIn, everywhere. Smart maintenance. Oh my God, this is such an amazing feature. Just in single go, it can save whole day for you. One day completely, like in a month, you can save at least 40 to 50 hours using this feature. Let me show you how. Suppose this is our script here. This is a locator page. Okay. And our script is failing for this XPath. For this XPath. So what you will do? You will copy this XPath.
Mm-hmm.
You will come here. You will, let's say, oh, I'm on this page. Or suppose now you have a CrowPath. You will do, you paste here. You got one of one matching node. It, suppose it was not one of one, you will fix it, right? And then you mm-hmm. will, after fixing, you will copy and come back here. You will paste that XPath, right? And then you will again execute your test case.
Right.
Right? Or in a single go, you will fix all those XPath. No, you will fix this XPath, then you will again execute your script. And then suppose your XPath got failed for this element. Now you will copy this XPath. You will copy this XPath. You will come back here, you will paste it, you found zero, then you will fix this XPath, right? Then again, you will, after fixing, you will come back here, you will paste it here, then again, you will execute your script. If I'm not mm-hmm. saying same thing, what you are doing, just let me know.
Yeah, exactly what
so
we do.
So are you with me? Like, we do this way, right?
Right.
Yeah.
One by one.
This mostly. Way, suppose any, yeah, if any change happen in your UI, then you will be like, okay, this XPath got failed, this XPath got failed, and you will, for sure, you will get frustrated. You can't fix like hundreds of XPath in single go in one day. And that's where, that is the reason that everybody used to, our automation script, and in industry, most of the automation script used to go in backlog, and people don't maintain them. Because UI automation is all about maintenance. Writing is automation script for one page, you can do it immediately, I can do it immediately, anybody can write in like 1 hour for one page automation. But whether they will run tomorrow or not, that is the challenge. To keep them running for months or years, that is the challenge. But no, but we never thought about that. So we have solved this problem now. You need not to copy XPath one by one or fix them. What you do, let's say your developer told you that this happened, change happened in the UI. What you will do, you will copy complete script, complete thing. You need not to segregate the XPath as well. You see, you come here. There is a smart maintenance logo here. Click on this. There's a click to copy all XPath. Click on this. Now you paste your complete script here, complete page here. Okay. And the similar thing, what we have done there, wherever you have written your XPath, just replace that with XPath value and copy that command. Just let's say, yeah, this is the only thing. We can copy this. Paste it here. Click on OK. See the magic. All your XPath from got fetched from your script, and it is showing you all occurrences here that this XPath is 2, this is 0, this is 1, this is 0, 0. So, and this is how you got to know that these all XPath got changed. Now, whether should I maintain this script or should I write my fresh script? This is up to you. Or you, if it is just like 4-5 XPath got changed out of 100,000, you can just fix 4-5 and then you start executing your script. In place of wasting full day thinking about should I in this script, should I maintain one by one, this is, here you go. And if you have somewhere written like thousands of XPath like this, let's say you have just XPath, you want to verify XPath only. So let me just delete this, or if you don't want. So you can verify the XPath as well. Suppose you have some XPaths, like these are the XPath, these many XPaths you have. So what you do, just paste these XPath here. Here, turn off this command, click on OK. It will verify all the XPath in single go. This is the unique and very first innovation which allows you, which gives you the power to verify all your XPath in single go. There's nothing like this ever possible before.
Amazing. Right.
Suppose you have this kind of script, like many people, like basic script we have written somewhere.
Right. Okay. We mostly write like driver.
Yes. What you have to do, suppose you, if it got, it is failing for you or something happened, what you do, you copy this completely. You need not to segregate those import statement and all. Copy these all. come back here, open this. Here we have some command. You paste it here. And what is the command here? We have this driver.findElement. Copy this, and it's telling you, it will tell you that what you have to do. So replace this XPath with XPath value here. And once that command is correct, it will show. Okay, and you see all XPath got fetched. 8 XPath was there in the script, and it is telling all the occurrences and everything. You can fix them immediately. You see how many were there? 5 and 3, 8 were there. All of them it got fetched, and it is showing you the occurrences. So this is how it makes your life so easy. And this is the reason that it is being used in by more than 500,000 users, almost like 6 lakhs we are hitting now, and almost in 180 plus countries, including companies like Google, Facebook, Apple, Microsoft, everywhere it is being used. And not just being used, it is being added as skills in their profile as well.
Nice. Yeah.
And now let me show you one more amazing thing which you will be amazed.
All right.
Yeah, so you know, like we all write the, let's say suppose you're a developer or a tester, whatever. If we have developed any functionality, let's say I have developed the search functionality on LinkedIn. Okay, so before testing it, for sure we will be before giving it for testing to a tester, definitely we will be doing a basic round of testing. I believe like everybody used to do, even if we are automation test engineer, before pushing our code to Git or production, we always do at least basic round of testing, isn't it? We do. So suppose we have developed a functionality, search functionality on LinkedIn. Now, before giving it to tester, we will test it, but we always explain as well, like what are the features or what are the steps testers has to follow to test these features. But what happened, like when tester will start testing, what they will do, they will test, they will find some bug, they will come back to developer, they will say, this is, I found this bug. And then developer will be scratching his head, he will be looking for that bug, and after spending 10 minutes of time, depending on the like issue, they will find that this bug is invalid because what happened, you have missed some steps. And this happened a lot, like, and if like, and then developer has to tell, look, you have missed these steps, you have missed this scenario, that's why you are getting bug, this is not a bug. Then developer or tester will go back to his seat, he will again doing the testing. This is one scenario. We miscommunication, basically what I say, the communication gap is there a lot, because developer will not write the steps and give it to in Notepad or in Excel to you, that these are the test case you have to test, these are the scenario you have to test this functionality. And second scenario, suppose as a tester I'm doing the testing and I got some bug. To reproduce that issue, it takes sometimes too much time, and sometimes even we are not able to reproduce that issue because we forgot the steps. Suppose after 30 steps you got some bug, would you be able to immediately reproduce that bug, or would you be able to remind all those 30 steps? No, not at all. So this is another scenario, and these are things where we are wasting a lot more time, and we don't have any solution unless we don't write all the steps manually. Okay, I clicked here, I typed here, then I right click here, then I again entered user ID and all. Third scenario is like, let's say suppose we got any bug in production, then either tester will be blaming developer will be blaming tester and each other, saying that no, this got missed on testing, this got missed on development, and nobody will be having proof because nobody likes to write the manual test cases, nobody likes to write the English test cases, right? So we have introduced this solution, single click solution. You need not to do anything extra. We have developed search functionality on LinkedIn. What you do here in CrowPath, click on this CrowPath Studio. Now see the magic. So let's say we have, I was working on search functionality. So before giving it for testing, I will be doing this testing. I'm doing my basic testing. I search for CrowPath. I clicked on people. I clicked on next. I clicked on two. Let's say I click on this profile. Okay, so these many things I did. Now, okay, stop. Let's say. Okay, so you see the magic here. This was the Cropathy Studio. What I was doing my basic functionality testing of search functionality. You see what all you got without doing anything. You got all these steps here. Open website, enter search, Cropath, hit, then I press enter, then I click on people, then I click on page two, then I click on the profile, the person profile. You got all these steps here. You got all the data here. Now what you can do, you click on this copy, you can paste in the chat to your tester that look, these are the steps you have to follow to test this search functionality. And you can also save this test case. You can rename the test case here. You see here, if you are an automation test engineer, you got the automation commands as well here. You got the data here. You got all these steps here. So now before giving your build for testing to the tester, you can tell them, look, you have to follow these steps to test this functionality. He will not come back to you with invalid bug for sure. Now if you got any issue, if you got any bug, to reproduce, you can, as a tester, you can look back to these steps to reproduce. You did not even reproduce the issue. You can just share these steps to developer directly, like, look, these are the steps, I got this issue, can you fix that? Immediately developer can also refer the document and he can fix the issue, he can reproduce the issue. And you can save this as a proof, like if any issue comes in production, you can show it to your manager or development and you can refer that whether you have done this testing or not, why this issue came in production. If you are an automation test engineer or automation developer, you are writing automation script, here you got all the complete command and with XPath for each step. You can perform now, you can done. What you have to do, nothing, you just clicked on this Cropathy Studio icon before starting your basic testing. Just a single click and you got everything ready made for you yourself, and you saved a lot more time with the Cropathy Studio. Amazing it is. This is incredible, I believe, and it's saving a lot more time. Here are some of the achievements of Cropath: more than 500,000 downloads, being used in 180 plus countries, almost highest rated in its category. Developers calls it lifesaver. These are the companies, like almost pretty much every company, those who are dealing with automation framework, some of them are still not on this page. So you see everybody is using Autonomic Cropath. This is the world map look like for Cropath. I will be present in all these conferences. So if anybody is looking for like meeting me or have any doubt, you can come and join in a step in forum. And with that, yeah, thank you. Pramod, over to you if you have any question.
Yeah, thanks Sanjay for this wonderful demo, and especially the tutorial for any kind of a beginner who is like struggling for especially with the automation scripts, locators and manual test cases, especially generating that English and that manual test cases is amazing feature. So I just wanted to know, like, I have a couple of questions, like, what is your future plan after this means?
So yes, so there are like lots more features coming in, and we are always keep working hard to try to think like what all manual things developers or testers are following which we can automate. So the very first thing which will be coming up next is like we are optimizing the complete algorithm of XPath generation here. So whatever you see, I can like immediately, I can promise that very soon it will be coming out as a third anniversary gift for our users, though I haven't announced. So here I'm like on your platform, very first time I'm announcing this. I was keeping it secret that I didn't even tell in my company as well this thing, that I'm working something and to optimize the XPath generation logic and some more features which can change the history again. So yes, those features are coming soon. So that is the recent plan. And yes, in future there are a lot more. For 7.0 we have so many amazing features. So like today you got amazed by these features. I'm sure like you will say just wow with those features once those will be announced.
I'm sure.
And we have our Autonomic Cropath community as well. So before building any feature or anything start working on, we used to share all those features that, look, these are the features we are suggesting for 7.0. Then we ask the user feedback and everybody feedback or suggestion, like what features you want to see, or if you have any suggestion, you just let us know, or if any bug is there, you can let us know. Always happy to help, always happy to implement those features and fix those issues for them. So yes, it is like community product for everyone. So yes.
All right. So if I have certain things or projects or some kind of feature that I would like to basically implement and all, so how can I contact you especially or anyone from?
Yes, sure. So see, if you open Cropart tab here, like everything is there, and already I have given my like social media here. You can connect me over Twitter, LinkedIn, everywhere, anywhere on any social media. And when you open Cropart tab here, I would request always look at this footer. It has all the information here itself. Like you can join the Slack channel. I'm pretty much active on the Slack channel here. So Cropart Slack channel is there. So many people are already there. Here is the Git repo where you can, if you have any issue or anything, you can always raise here. I always immediately look and fix them within a 1 day, 2 days, hardly I will take. And then you can all the link, you can join the community here. And here is the, like, you can follow Cropart handlers on all the social media platform to get the latest update and everything about Cropart. And here always you can refer here the change. This is a change log page here. You can always refer this page, like what all changes happen in the next release or for all the browsers. So all those details are here.
Okay. Wonderful. So I guess thanks Sanjay for this wonderful demo, especially the tutorial part of it. And if anyone has a question, probably they are going to ask in the comment section and we can discuss that later part in that case.
Sure.
All right. So thanks a lot, Sanjay, for this awesome, again, end-to-end session, fully, you can say, full-on tutorial how to use it properly, right, as a pro. Thanks a lot, Sanjay.
Thank you, Pramod. Yeah, thank you. And it was great pleasure, and I really appreciate your help and support for the community and what kind of work you are doing. Looking forward to have more webinars with you, and I'll always there to support your community and everyone. So yeah, with that, thank you so much. It was nice.
Thanks a lot, Sanjay. Same to you.
Have a good day. Be safe.
Bye. Okay. Have a good day. Bye.